I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, I'm gonna let the reason out that his love goes on forever. I'm gonna take it all the way.
Hey, welcome back to the Maple Minute this Tuesday, January 17th, 2023. I'm Pastor Bill. We've been looking at building quality friendships, and today we're going to talk about how not to choose a friend. That's sort of negative, but sometimes I think it's important that we learn this. See, for better or worse, we need people, and that's just the bottom line. But, and it is God-given that we are social, and that's why we need people. And there are so many blessings that we can talk about in having good friends, but there's also the danger that when we open up our lives to the wrong people, it would damage us. You know, there are some kind of friends that we just don't need in life. And probably the best illustration biblically that I can give you is the tragic life of King Joash. King Joash was a young child when he became king, and he became king under the influence of a godly priest named Jehoiada. But the problem was Jehoiada, a man of God, the priest, the high priest in Israel, he was 90 years older than Joash. Joash became king when he was 7. He took the throne of Judah, that is the southern half of the split kingdom of Israel. And under Jehoiada, Joash did some great things. He was spiritually and politically successful. But remember, he's a lot older. In 2 Chronicles chapter 24, verses 17 and 18, the Bible says, after the death of Jehoiada, the officials of Judah came and paid homage to the king, and he listened to them. And that's going to be a problem. In verse 18, they abandoned the temple of their Lord, the God of their ancestors, and worshiped Asherah poles and idols. Because of their guilt, God's anger came on Judah and Jerusalem. You see, under the influence of ungodly friends, ungodly people, Joash led his nation into sin. He was responsible for the murder of his mentor, Jehoiada's son, the prophet Zechariah. And he experienced military defeat at the hands of a weak, small Syrian army. In fact, Joash fell so far from the way of God that his own servants, eventually they assassinate him, and his subjects refused to allow him to be buried in the tombs of all the kings of Judah in Jerusalem. That's how much they disrespect him. See, what we learn here is that Joash, he really didn't need those friends. They didn't help him in any way. And many of our associations in life, we can't always control. You can't help sometimes the people you work around. You didn't control them. You can't fire them or any of those things. But here's what we do know. Here's what we can choose. Our friends and the people with whom we choose to spend time have an enormous impact on our character and values. And if we realize that, then we can learn to choose who we spend the most time with, who we do that. The Apostle Paul said something similar as he's writing to the church at Corinth in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 33. He even quotes a Greek poet of the day, a guy named Menander, and he says this. He says, don't be misled, and then he quotes, this is the quote, bad company corrupts good character. I think these are things that every parent wishes their kids would understand, but so often it's hard for young people to understand that their parents are really looking out for them. You see, though, it's a principle, though, sometimes we focus so much on the young and kids and teenagers, but you realize Joash was over 30 years old when his choice of friends derailed his life. Solomon, the guy that we're going to look about his writings, Proverbs, Solomon was much older than that when his wives, so many of them, he had 300 wives and 700 concubines, substitute wives, they stole his heart from God. You know, the Bible says, in fact, Solomon wrote this, Proverbs 13, verse 20, and this is a great verse. This is something when I was a youth pastor, I always talked to the teens about. Walk with the wise and become wise, for a companion of fools suffers harm. Some of the other translations say will be destroyed. And that's true. Your friends do determine your future, your destiny. Your friends, now you can't blame your choices on them, but they do influence you. So if you want to have a good future, show me your friends and I'll show you your future is the saying that we've always embraced for a long time. And that's true. If you want to have a good future, have good friends. If you don't care and you don't check it out, you might end up like Joash, who was a ruler and could have done better, but eventually he let it fall apart. So I hope this helps you. Let's take some time to think it through with some questions. Number one, are friendships important? We should always ask that question first. Are friendships important? And your answer, yes or no, let me ask the follow-up, why or why not? If they are important, what safeguards do you have on your friendships? And maybe you've never really contemplated this, but why or why not are your friendships important, and what safeguards should you have? If you don't have any, should you have safeguards, and what should they be? Secondly, what kind of impact do your friends and the people you spend most of the time with have on your character and values? I think that's so important there, too. As we talked about this, the people we choose to spend the most time with are friends. They do impact. What are they impacting? How are your friends shaping you? And then thirdly and last of all, are friendships worth it? Why or why not? For what reason or reasons is it important to have good quality friends in your life? Those things are so true, and I would say this. Some of the most important people I've had as friends in life have really helped me. But I can also say there have been people in my life who, even as they claim to be Christians, even people who wanted to be mentors, they weren't so godly. They were sneaky. They were deceitful, liars, and things like that. And that really took a toll on my life. So I would say it's important. And most of all, as you go through and you determine your friendships, your relationships, and evaluate them, hey, take the time to make sure you're not evaluating by somebody else's standard, but by God's standard. So until next time, this has been the Maple Minute. I hope you got something out of it. If you did, take time to like us, share out our videos, and so that some of your friends, some of the other people you know, they might get some value out of them too. So thanks for joining us, and until next time, this has been the Maple Minute. I'm gonna praise Jesus' name, 'cause His love goes on forever. His love reaches to the highest mountain. His love stretches to the lowest valley. His love.